Hey guys, welcome back to Forks Life. In this episode, we're meeting up with a few friends and we have an astronomy event planned out and we're going to be going to see the Orion Nebula. We're going to head into the desert far away from the light pollution and we're going to see it and it's going to be quite fun. So make sure you stay tuned. We are like an hour's drive from our desert destination and behind me the car is like filled with the telescope and its equipment like the tripod and the eyepieces, and there are four cars following us. So now we're all settled down and Percy is having fun over there and Wani is playing with the kite. It's quite fun. Since it was very dusty and windy, we had to change our location, and during this someone got stuck, so now we have to do a recovery. Successful recovery.
हमारी टेस्ट दे रही थी विंड है
सब लोग गाड़ी खराब है एक दो बार तो समझ में आएगा कि यही जाना देखना चाहिए
Before watching the nebula, I'm going to be telling some information about it, and we're also going to be watching like some informational videos by NASA and stuff on the projector. So as we know, we are here today to view the Orion Nebula. So basically, what is a nebula? A nebula is a region of space in which there are some light gases like hydrogen and helium, some smaller quantities of some heavier gases, and also some dust. Now, all these gases sometimes coalesce together to form some denser areas, and these usually attract more mass, and these sometimes can become new stars. So you could think of a nebula as a sort of star factory. The Orion Nebula is located 1500 light years away from Earth. So since a light year is basically the distance traveled by light in 1 year, what we are going to be seeing today is the nebula as it would have been 1500 years ago, since that is when the light left the nebula. The Orion Nebula is the brightest nebula which we can see from Earth, and the source of all the brightness are the hundreds of stars which are formed inside it, and near the middle are the largest stars of the nebula. These are called the trapezium as they are arranged in a trapezoidal pattern. Yes. So basically, a nebula, since it is located so far away from us, the light takes such a long time to reach here. So it's like going back through history when we look to the night sky. So it is a very interesting thing. Now, even though the nebula which we're going to be seeing is denser than free space, it is still a stronger vacuum than can be created on Earth by the laboratories.
Nearby stars in the nebula. The excitation energy corresponds to the red end of the spectrum, and therefore reddish light is emitted.
When the gas in Orion's interstellar cloud collapsed under its weight, oatmeal clumps of hydrogen and dust were formed. The density and pressure within the center clumps caused a nuclear fusion and bore a trapezium star. An intense illumination ignited, releasing energy and stellar winds. This energy pushed open the interstellar cloud and formed a bowl-like cavity. When winds collide with other material radiating from the cloud, a bow shock is formed. The nebula's right side forms a rippling, curled edge from the impact of shocks on the dust and gas. The outflow from smaller stars near the rippled edge cut through the stationary gas and form beautiful, elongated jets. A thin veil of dust and gas overlaps the shallow bowl shape. Hubble's resolution reveals thousands of stars surrounding the highly illuminated area of the four trapezium stars. For the first time, an entire star formation history is presented to us in a rich treasury.
Oh my, those pincers are like an inch long. I think camel spiders are either not venomous or very slightly venomous, so they're definitely not life-threatening. And also, the thing that they jump onto camels and suck their blood dry is a myth. But still, this is still not something you would want to see crawling around your campsite, especially in the dark, especially near a small little girl. Get rid of the torch. Nice.
Take one.
Wait, it's okay. Woo, I got an extended one. Ooh, double. Ooh, magic.